traces of magic are somehow protecting the dragon. I need to break its connection to those traces of magic.
Stupid. much, do you?
Bombarda!
Expelliarmus!
forever, Ranrok. There's no way to
hide. Give up now! I have ensured that your death is swift!
Let me answer.
Thank you. Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well. yeah.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig. Well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly, and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
I can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did, but it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the Loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrock, Isadora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrock. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her. And she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more. I've thought about what you told me in the Great Hall. I would like to speak with you. Meet me in the Undercroft as soon as you can.